Hello and welcome to Kemper Bushcraft. And today you can see I am in my camp, my Kemper camp in my new shelter. It's the first overnight I'm doing here, and I call it Jol Overnighter. Jol is the old Viking or Nordic word for what we call Christmas today, and in Denmark we call it Jul. So Jul today and Jol many years ago. I think that was a good solution for my overnighter video here. Well, I'm very excited to stay out here with my new stove, see how much heat it can produce and give me in this shelter. And as you saw, I put up a screen or a cover in the front with some plastic. My intention was to buy something that was transparent, but I couldn't find that. But this one is also okay. It's white, but the light will come in, so it won't be totally dark in here. So, and when I roll them down, you see I have made it in two sections, a large one and a smaller one. The smaller one I can roll up and then use it as a door when I'm going in and out, perhaps during the night. So, when I have them down and the stove on the fire, I think there will be pretty warm and cozy in here. I hope so. And as you see, my my little table for my wooden box, where I have all my cooking utensils in, and about that, my rucksack. And to save space, I made it in that way that I can move my rucksack when I'm going to find something down in my box, my wooden box. So that's nice. And I relocated the skull from, I think it's perhaps it's a dog or a large fox, I don't know. It's a skull I found in the woods many years ago. And my hanger for my jackets, my anorak, is in place and I can use that. It's been raining a lot lately here in Denmark, actually almost every day. I have a few days where I have sun, and you saw that in my videos where I built my shelter here, but most it has been raining. And today There was not supposed to be rain, but now it's raining again. And I'm going to light up my fire in my fire pit and cook me a nice steak, and I'll show you that later. Then I have a new sleeping system, at least a new sleeping bag. I would like to show, I'm very excited for that. I'll show you that in a minute. And I'll begin to light up all the lights in here, and my folding Swiss Army lantern I have got from a very friendly subscriber down in Switzerland, I think. Yeah. So, and the clock is now around 3, and about an hour and a half it's going to be dark, so, and I can't eat that early, so I have to make some other stuff there. I have brought my carving set with me, and I think I'll start carving a little man. Yeah. But another thing, I bought such one. I think it's called carbon dioxide detector. It detects if the stove has any leaks and the harmful waves that will come out there. In Danish we call it koldioxid, CO2, and it's very dangerous. So I bought this that will detect if there's any leak, and will warn me in good time so I don't, in my sleep, will die. That is a risk, but I don't think the stove will be any problems, but to be on the safe side. So this I have bought. And I also bought a new lantern. This is not an original. I couldn't find that today, so this is the cheap one, but I think this one will do as well. Now I'm just sitting here enjoying the afternoon sun that is going down behind the hills and the trees, and smoking my pipe a little bit. And then I'll get back to you when I'm finished, and I'll show you my new sleeping bag. It's very awesome. Stay tuned. Yeah, and this is the bag I'm talking about, the sleeping bag. It's from One Tigress, a company in Canada, I think it is. And this is actually my first Dow sleeping bag. I never had one before. The ones I can find here in Denmark are very expensive. This one, this sleeping bag, only cost about $100, $99.99. And it's 100% duck down, and it can go down to minus 15 degrees Celsius. So this is the winter sleeping bag, and I brought that today. The company One Tigress have generously offered me to test one out, and I'm looking very much forward to that. I'm sure this one will keep me warm even in very cold conditions. today I have my stove with me, so in the beginning I won't probably not need all this isolation, but during the night when I'm not going to fire my stove anymore, I strongly believe that this one will keep me warm. And beside the sleeping bag, I have my wool blanket with me, always great to have. And in here I have a sleeping mat from Thermarest. It's not a winter sleeping mat, but I'm sure with the wool blankets and the reindeer fur, it will be quite cozy. So this one, and for a little luxury, a little pillow for my head. I need to sleep high with my head. But first, I'll take this one out. And of course, I had this for some weeks now. I was waiting for this moment where I could try it out. And back home, I had it not in this bag, but laying out on my bed. So it's really a cool sleeping bag. I have something I will show you inside. Hang on. And I'm losing light now, I can see, but of course it's a quality YK zipper. And inside is this. And this come along your body, and when you tighten this, the heat will be kept down in the sleeping bag. And up and here at the hood, I have this that I can tighten so that the sleeping bag will be very tight around my head. So minus 15 degrees Celsius, it's amazing. This sleeping bag is called Nordic Defense sleeping bag, and it weighs, let me see, 700 grams, 1.7 kilos. It's nothing, very lightweight. And when I'm going on my hikes and going to sleep out, I'll bring this with me. And okay, in the summer perhaps it's too hot, but here in autumn, winter and spring, it's perfect for me. So thank you very much, One Tigress, for letting me have one of these and testing it out. And I'm sure I'll be very cozy in this tonight. And I'll tell you in the morning how it was to sleep in a down sleeping bag for my first time. I'm looking very much forward to that. Now it's beginning to be a little bit cold, so I would like to take my jacket on again and just sit here and enjoying the afternoon. Yeah, and I also added a metal plate here from aluminium that will reflect the heat towards me. Some of my subscribers have been concerned about it's going to be too hot here, but I can assure you when it's burning and I take my hand here, it's not hot at all, but it's a good solution to reflect the heat from the wall towards me. So I would like to show you some things that some of my friendly subscribers have sent me. This one is from a guy called Andrew. Thank you so much, Andrew, for this. I really appreciate that. I can wear it on my belt, and I'll definitely do that when I'm out. I will call it I think it's a foraging pouch. I can collect different things in this pouch, tinder or mushrooms or anything. And it's made from what do you call it, used leather. So it's not new leather, but something that has been used before from some other purpose. And this one, I really like it, Andrew. It's so nice and it's so compact. When I do this and fold it up, it doesn't take much room, and well, it's very old school. I like it. And Andrew has made this himself. I'm amazed. Very nice handcraft leather. I couldn't do it as good as this, I think. Put some antler on here and here, and this little brass that I can hang stuff from. So I'm very glad for this, Andrew. Thank you very much. And I'm amazed about your skills, I must say. And then from Steve, I got some stuff from him, and I can see that Steve knows exactly what I like. A very wonderful little sheath for a knife, and it's actually made for my Isula knife. I can put it down here, and I can use it as a neck knife or wear it around my belts, in my belts. It's very cool. He's not made this himself, Steve, but one of his friends has. Very nice handcrafted leather work. And then he sent me this pieces of antler from a deer. And of course, for my leather works and so on, I love antlers. I have a lot of use for these, and very grateful for that. So thank you very much, Steve. I appreciate that. And last but not least, a little compass of brass. It's very awesome. I never seen one in brass before. It's very old school, and Steve said got it from a friend, I think, and he thought I should have it. Thank you very much, Steve. It's so great, very old school compass. I love it, and it's going to be on my rucksack from now on. I can promise you that. So thank you very much, Steve. I appreciate that, and also you, Andrew. You are good friends, and I'm very grateful when you're sending me stuff. Thank you very much. It's like Christmas. I'm just so lucky to be in that position that people are friendly and want to send me things. Thank you. Now it's so cold, I decided to light up my stove, and already now I can feel the heat. It's so great to have such a thing in my shelter. And this is what I'm going to eat tonight. I have some potatoes I will slice and some big mushrooms. And then I have this, a big, big steak. Let's look at it. Yeah, a brontosaurus steak. It's really awesome. I eat it before and it's very good meat. Now I'm going to let the fire be to coal and then I can put on my BBQ grill and grill this steak and the potatoes. But first I have to cut my potatoes and look at this. My Opinel. I made it black. Both the handle, but also the blade. It gone blue, I think it's called. Yeah, and this in here. Something I made. I have some small jars with spices in. Montreal spice. This is basilicum. And this is salt with garlic in. And of course I have my little one here with paprika and salt and pepper. And as you can see here, the fire is going nicely, and I just have to wait until there's not much flame so I can make my steak over this grill. This is a brontosaurus steak. I don't know if I said that before. It's from a dinosaur. Some of you maybe don't know that there's dinosaurs in Denmark. And it tastes very delicious, I must say.
Now I'm getting hungry now, so to speed up the process, I will do what this awesome grill can do, the BDBQ. You can have it in three positions, and I just lower it down. The one I've used now is number two. It can be higher, but now I'm going to the lowest level to come closer to the coals and hopefully speed up the process of having something to eat. Let's see how this is doing. Yeah, it's okay. Oh, it's looking good. And I can feel the potatoes are beginning to be soft. Yeah. Now I think the meat is done and all the rest too. I'll take this one to put it on. Yeah. Doesn't it look nice? Brontosaurus steak. This one have to cook a little bit more. And my camera is not so good for this low light, so I'm not sure if you can see it, but yeah, I'm going to see how the steak is. Would you like to come closer? Okay.
Sitting here by my stove, it's awesome, very cozy. Mmm, so delicious. Mustn't forget the beer. Skål, everyone. And gladly yod. That means Merry Christmas. And this is a juleøl, julebrew, Christmas brew. It's always a great taste. Skål. Ah, nice. Did I mention that the spice on the meat is Montreal steak spice? Many of the the big bushcrafter YouTubers are recommending that, and I have a friend in the USA that sent me some spice, and it is very great, I must say. We don't have something like that in Denmark. And I actually put the spice on a couple of hours before I cooked it, because then it's going into the meat and giving a really nice taste. Mm. See how it looks without additional lighting on. And I won't eat all the meat because I want to give something back to the nature. And I know there's a fox here in this forest, so I think he'll be, or she will be, very pleased with that nice piece of red meat. Yeah. A little treat. Christmas present from Kimber Bushcraft. And the fire is burning inside my stove. Easy and warm. And something that I have wondered about. There's some black spots here, and that's from the sod. But some of the sod actually have disappeared. Yeah. It's a really cool stove. I love it very much. And in here, I think there's about 15 degrees. I'll check it in a moment, but sitting here, yeah, it's like home. Well, it's better than home. Don't tell my wife that. Yeah. And that's right, this is my old kuksa. And it's a very sad story. When I was out here in my last video, I thought, well, it is a little bit heavy in the bottom, so I decided to grind it. And to save some time, never do that, I used a grinding machine or a sander. And when I did that in the bottom, I got so close that I actually had 2 holes in my kuksa. So all my work was wasted, and I have to make me a new one. But now I hope I have found out how it's going to be done without cracking. I hope so. And I got a piece of birch wood back home so I can make another kuksa. But of course it's sad that my very fine kuksa was destroyed by that, and because I was impatient, that's not good, and I learned a lesson. So this is my old kuksa. It will do for now until I have time to make the other one. Skål. And I can say it's actually rather hot in here. I'm actually considering taking my jacket off because where I'm sitting, it's at least 20 degrees. It's so nice. So now I have closed my plastic curtains and I'm going to bed now. I lay out my sleeping system. Yeah. Underneath my sleeping pad I have my reindeer skin and my one tigress sleeping bag. So I'm looking very much forward to that. And I can say at the moment in here, let's see. Yeah, 22 degrees. It's been near the stove, so I can't use that because it's too close to the stove. I'll put it here, and then I'll see in half an hour how warm it is in here. I put up my jackets, and it's warm in here, so I'm going to take my trousers off and keep this one on and then see how it goes tonight. If I'm going to be cold, then I have a little fleece here I can use, but I don't think that will be necessary. It's been a wonderful night here, evening. There's no wind and very calm, so it's been a good start for a new beginning. And this is the view from where I'm laying. It's so nice. Yeah, I really appreciate to have the opportunity to do these things. And over here you can see the plastic. It's working very nicely. And of course, in a moment I'll put out all the lights in here and only have my little stove there giving me the light in here. And as I said before, I think I'll put some logs on and perhaps do it again in a couple of hours and then see. In the morning there should be about 0 degrees Celsius, so it will be cold, so I want to test this sleeping bag under these conditions. So just playing here and watch the fire. It's amazing. I can't describe it. It's so awesome. Good night, everyone. Well, good morning, everyone. Yeah, it's morning. It's not a great weather. The wind is coming from the east, so it's blowing down in my camp. Not in my shelter, but it's not cozy to be here when it's damp and cold and windy. But it's been a wonderful night. The temperature dropped to about 0 degrees Celsius, the freezing point, and I must say, my sleeping bag from One Tigris did the job. I didn't freeze at all, and especially my feet. I always used to have cold feet, but this morning it was warm and nice, so a very good sleeping bag indeed. Now I'm preparing my breakfast. I'll use the stove to make some bacon and eggs, and hopefully get the warm by that way, and also a cup of coffee. Yeah. Well, this is all for now, folks. I hope you enjoy my little Jule overnighter here in my new Kimber camp, my new shelter. It's been a wonderful hike overnighter, and I'm planning to do one again in January. Hopefully there'll be a little more winter, perhaps some snow. I hope so. It'd be cool to be out here in a snowstorm or something like that, I think. And I'm not sure I'm going to make more films this year. I don't know, perhaps, but if I don't, I wish you all a happy holiday, Merry Christmas, and whatever you are celebrating. And I hope to see you again on the next one. Bye bye, and take care.